In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, and what I have done and what I have felt today. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who renew the world through mysteries beyond all telling, grant, we pray, that your church may be guided by your eternal design, and not be deprived of your help in this present age. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Del libro del profeta Isaías. Esto dice el Señor: voy a crear un cielo nuevo y una tierra nueva. Ya no recordaré lo pasado, lo olvidaré de corazón. Se llenarán ustedes de gozo y de perpetua alegría por lo que voy a crear. Convertiré a Jerusalén en júbilo y a mi pueblo en alegría. Me alegraré por Jerusalén y me gozaré por mi pueblo. Ya no se oirán en ella gemidos ni llantos. Ya no habrá niños que vivan pocos días, ni viejos que no colmen sus años. Y al que no los alcance, se le tendrá por maldito. Construirán casas y vivirán en ellas. Plantarán viñas y comerán sus frutos. Palabra de Dios. Te alabaré, Señor, eternamente.
Te alabaré, Señor, eternamente.
Te alabaré, Señor, pues no dejaste que se rieran de mí mis enemigos. Tú, Señor, me salvaste de la muerte y a punto de morir me reviviste. Te alabaré, Señor, eternamente. Alaben al Señor quienes lo aman. Den gracias a su nombre, porque su ira dura un solo instante y su bondad toda la vida. El llanto visita por la tarde, por la mañana el júbilo. Te alabaré, Señor, eternamente. Escúchame, Señor, y compadécete. Señor, ven en mi ayuda. Convertiste mi duelo en alegría. Te alabaré por eso eternamente. Te alabaré, Señor, eternamente.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of eternal glory. See good and not evil, so that you may live, and the Lord will be with you. Praise to you, Lord Jesus. At that time, Jesus left Samaria for Galilee, for Jesus himself testified that a prophet has no honor in his native place. When he came into Galilee, the Galileans welcomed him, since they had seen all he had done in Jerusalem at the feast, for they themselves had gone to the feast. Then he returned to Cana in Galilee, where he had made the water wine. Now there was a royal official whose son was ill in Capernaum. When he heard that Jesus had arrived in Galilee from Judea, he went to him and asked him to come down and heal his son, who was near death. Jesus said to him, "Unless your people see signs and wonders, you will not believe." The royal official said to him, "Sir, come down before my child dies." Jesus said to him, "You may go. Your son will live." The man believed that Jesus said to him. The man believed what Jesus said to him and left. While the man was on his way back, his slaves met him and told him that his boy would live. He asked them when he began to recover. They told him, "The fever left him yesterday about 1 in the afternoon." The father realized that just at that time, Jesus had said to him, "Your son will live." And he and his whole household came to believe. Now this was the second sign Jesus did when he came to Galilee from Judea. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. In this story, we hear the faith of someone who wasn't a disciple of Jesus, but believed in the power that Jesus had to heal. And Jesus chooses to grant this miracle for this person's son. The son was sick. The father believed that Jesus could help. He asked Jesus for help. And Jesus worked a miracle. Jesus said before working the miracle that they would not believe unless they saw signs, unless that he worked this miracle. And he did. And this is one of the things that brought people to Christ and helped them to believe that he was from heaven, was the miracles that he had worked. And you and I already have faith in Jesus. We already know that he can do anything. And we cannot rely, guarantee, that if we ask him for a miracle that we'll receive it. Not at this time, at least. You and I have faith that every single person who believes in him, who accepts his love and salvation, will be healed. But the question is when. We know that he has the power to raise people from the dead. And we know, therefore, that he also has the power to heal and to restore a person, and to even to glorify them beyond any state that they have been before. When do we believe this will happen? It happens, we know for sure, promise will be given to us that happens after death when Jesus comes again. We know that he can work these miracles. The question is, when will he work? It wouldn't be appropriate for us to rely on miracles when it comes to this virus. We need to try to not put God to the test. We need to try to do what we can to keep from receiving this virus ourselves or passing it on to others. And if we are sick or others are sick, we need to encourage them to seek regular medical treatment. You and I have faith, but that doesn't mean that Jesus is going to decide that we need to see the signs and wonders in order to believe. That may be something that already has happened for us and for our family members. Jesus might not decide to grant the miracle now. He may choose to grant it later, the miracle of healing. Solo queremos saber que esta es la historia sobre un milagro de sanación de un papá que pidió a Jesús por la sanación de su hijo. Él tenía Jesús respondió, ellos que esta generación solo va a creer a través de milagros, signos, maravillosos. Pero no es una garantía que cuando estamos pidiendo a Jesús, con fe, que Él va a hacer un milagro con nosotros horrible. Hay una promesa que eventualmente vamos a recibir. Cada persona que cree en Jesús y acepta la tentación de su amor y salvación, va a recibir una sanación. También una resurrección. También una glorificación. Pero no hay garantía que vamos a recibir ahorita, en este mundo, en este tiempo. Jesús tiene que elegir. Él tiene libre hacer milagro y no ser milagro temprano, ahorita. Pero tenemos esa garantía de cuando Él vino por la segunda vez, cada persona va a recibir el milagro de la sanación y glorificación y resurrección. Tenemos que usar nuestro capaz a mantener nuestra salud. Una capaz natural. Tenemos fe que Jesús puede ayudarnos a través de milagros, pero no vamos a confiar que vamos a recibir esos milagros ahorita. Tenemos que guardar nuestra salud a través de elecciones naturales en nuestras vidas. También queremos cuidar que a nuestra salud, que no queremos dar esta enfermedad a otras personas. Quiero decir que está bien a tener una fe fuerte. Está bien que vamos a creer en la resurrección de todos los humanos. Pero tenemos que guardar, no vamos a tratar a Dios. Tenemos que guardarnos solo a través de las maneras naturales. Juntos vamos a ofrecer oraciones por la iglesia y por el mundo. Por la iglesia, que Dios va a cuidar todos los sacerdotes que están sirviendo a su gente, roguemos al Señor. We want to pray also for the leaders in our government, in our communities, in our hospitals, that they will make good decisions, that they will try to find ways to make available what we need. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Queremos orar por los enfermos, que ellos van a recibir ayuda, que personas van a compartir que ellos tienen cuando hay necesidad. Roguemos al Señor. We want to pray for our parish. We pray that God continue to keep us healthy. We want to pray especially for our elderly, that God help them to show us the strength and faith in Jesus Christ at this time. We pray to the Lord. También por las intenciones de esa misa, para el eterno descanso de Cristina Caballero, el Otero González Flores y Aurelia Durán, roguemos al Señor. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your guarantee, for your promise that things like this virus cannot take away our salvation or your love for us. We ask you to continue to lead us and guide us, help us to make good choices, help us to remain healthy, and help us to receive miracles, Lord, if you permit it. We ask this through Christ our Lord. bendecirás, y ahora te presentamos, nacerá para nosotros pan de vida.
Bendito seas por siempre, Señor.
Bendito seas, Señor Dios universo, precedido, fruto de vida y del hombre, que recibimos de tu generosidad, y ahora te presentamos a ser para nosotros de vida y de salvación. Bendito seas por siempre, para que ese sacrificio mío de ustedes se agrade a Dios Padre Todopoderoso. Te rogamos, Señor, que podamos alcanzar el fruto de la ofrenda de que te presentamos, para que purificados en la santísima situación de pecado, nos renueve la participación en la vida divina, por Jesucristo nuestro Señor. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Fieles a la recomendación del Salvador y siguiendo su divina enseñanza, nos adoraremos a decir. Padre nuestro, que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre. Venga a nosotros tu reino, hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día. Perdona nuestras ofensas como también nosotros perdonamos los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en tentación y líbranos del mal. Líbranos de todos los males, Señor, y concédenos la paz en nuestros días, para que ayudados por tu misericordia, vivamos siempre libres de pecado y protegidos de toda perturbación, mientras esperamos la gloriosa venida de nuestro Salvador Jesucristo. Dios el reino,
te llamo
de la gloria, siempre, Señor. Señor Jesucristo, que dijiste a tus apóstoles, la paz es de que mi paz es hoy. No tengas en cuenta nuestros pecados, sino en fe de tu iglesia, y conforme a tu palabra, concédele la paz y unidad, tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos. La paz del Señor esté siempre con ustedes. Dense fraternamente la paz. Cordero de Dios que quitas el pecado del mundo, ten piedad de nosotros. Cordero de Dios, que quitas el pecado del mundo, ten piedad de nosotros. Cordero de Dios, que quitas el pecado del mundo, danos la paz. Este es el poder de Dios, que quita el pecado del mundo. Dichosos los invitados a la cena del Señor. Infundiré mi espíritu en ustedes, y los haré según mis preceptos, y cumple mis mandamientos, dice el Señor.
Queremos decir gracias a Dios por su presencia que está con nosotros, también para pedir por milagros, pero confía especialmente también en la resurrección que viene.
May your holy gifts, O Lord, we pray, give us life by making us new, and by sanctifying us, lead us to things eternal through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Renew your people within and without, O Lord, and since it is your will that they may be unhindered by wildly delights, give them, we pray, perseverance in their spiritual intent through Christ our Lord. Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Thanks be to God. Salve.